Well, guys, here's where I'm at so far. I'm about 7.5 hours in. Seriously. I changed upper and lower A-arms, front and rear. This is a push-pull style steering setup, which is a cluster. The plastic battery box doesn't want to fit. All the machined aluminum pieces have a really pretty gunmetal gray, which unfortunately doesn't match anything on my car, but it actually kind of looks chocolate brown. It's not, but it's what it looks like. The machining is pretty good on the conversion kit. The hardware is junk. And it's missing a whole bunch of screws and parts, and I'm just kind of scabbing shit together and trying to make it work. But it sucks. You put it all together and then it's not right, and then you have to take it all apart again and do it over. But I kind of cheated a little bit. I was using Team Fast Eddie's video from the Castle Creations kit, which I believe this was copied from. That's pretty similar. I would say about 85-90% similar. This only has two motor mounts on it holes for two motor mount screws instead of three like on the Castle kit. But all in all, I guess for the price, it's not too bad. It just would be nice if it were a little more complete. Things like, I mean, it didn't come with zip ties to hold the motor fans on. So I kind of did it myself. So there's two zip ties going this way here, two zip ties here. Because, of course, my zip ties are only 8 inches long. If I had 12 or 14s, it probably would have been fine. But it was just slightly too short. I probably put them on wrong. But as soon as I went to tighten them up, it squirted off this end over here. So I threw another zip tie on and pulled them in together so that way they can't fall off. But those red arms, I don't know if you saw the previous video or not, but these arms here were red. I stripped them down with Easy Off and buffed them out of my buffing wheel and then cleared them. So that took 45 minutes to an hour to do all that too, so that's part of what took me so long. Eventually I'm going to get all this white nylon off of here. When I bought the thing, I loved the look of the white nylon. It looked so cool. Until the first time I ran it, and then it turned dirty. But one nice thing about the A-arm kit that I bought, these are, like I said, this is Rovan's nylon version 2. Look how tight this stuff is. I mean, there is no sloppiness at all. Now up front, different story. Up and down, slippity sloppity. There, you can see that. Isn't a real big deal, I guess, but I hate floppy wheels, man. It just reminds me of a toy, you know, of like a Toys R Us car. But I don't know how they want you to mount the servo horn to the servo while it's installed in the car. There's no access holes to get to it. So how the hell are you supposed to tighten the screw up? So I did probably what most of you guys would do. I haven't cleaned up the hole yet, but I just blew a hole in the chassis so I can get right in there and throw a screw in there. But speaking of screws, short two screws there, and of course they're an odd size that I don't have, so I ordered some. But it's not a bad kit. It takes a minute to figure everything out. If it had instructions or something, it would definitely be a lot easier to put together. But like I said, it is frustrating. You put it together and then have to tear it back apart. And it's like, son of a bitch, you know, you're just wasting your time. Your hands are bloody and raw because none of the screws are... Nothing lines up. We'll just put it that way. I mean, it seemed like the whole chassis was just tweaked. It isn't, but it just seemed like it. So you had to back off every damn screw that you've put in so you can assemble it and then tighten them all up a little bit at a time in order to get the chassis to lay flat. Otherwise, it's tweaking up so bad that this thing won't even lay down in the car. What a pain. But I know, bitch. But I'm thinking it's going to be pretty neat when it's done. I don't know what to do about these XT150 connectors. I don't have anything that runs XT150s. And I don't really plan on switching everything over. So I can't find an adapter to go from an XT150 to, let's say, Traxxas. But I don't know. I guess I'm just going to have to bite the bullet and cut the ends off and put Traxxas connectors on them, because that's what I run on everything. I mean, I know a lot of guys run XT90s or E3s or IC3s or whatever they are. These things. And I mean, that's fine. Everybody has their taste. I've had good luck with the Traxxas connectors, so I think I'm going that route. If I can get the wires to fit in there. Those ends aren't very big in there, but yeah, we'll find out. This 8-gauge wire is pretty heavy duty stuff. In case anybody's wondering, there is actually 6 capacitors in this. 3 here, and there's another 3 in there. I always wondered, because it kind of looked like it in the pictures, but yes, it does. Well, hopefully the next video is of this thing out ripping around in the yard and getting stupid and me having fun with a big cheese-eating grin on my face. But I'm a little nervous because this is after watching Kevin Talbot videos, watching his XL2s blow up, I'm like, man, I don't want to light this thing in my house. Or, you know, fire it up in the house and have it go off on me. I don't know, I guess it made me a wimp. Oh, well. But, well, I guess I'll yak at you guys later. See ya.